right, coming up next, we get to this middleweight bout between Anderson the Spider Silva and Uriah Hall. Well, he's one of the more accomplished strikers in this division. Sprawl and brawl, whatever you want to say, he's going to try to keep this fight standing tonight.
It does not matter how he accomplishes it. All he wants to do is be on his feet and at range, hitting you with the beautiful jab, staying away from the grappling exchanges. You don't accomplish all the things that this man has accomplished over the course of his career without understanding distance. He has great distance management, which then in turn allows him to land all these beautiful, diverse kicks, spinning back kick, jumping high kick, so many things he possesses that he will try to use tonight in this fight.
Yeah, if this turns into a kickboxing match tonight, most people believe, yeah, his opponent is in a world of trouble. All right, so here he is, the former UFC middleweight champion, Anderson Silva. The pro record doesn't look like it did a few years ago, DC, but most people still inject the name Anderson Silva into the discussion of the greatest MMA fighters of all time.
It's because Anderson is doing us a favor every time he steps foot in the octagon. He could have walked away and protected the record, but the lure, the draw of fighting still is pulling at the Spider. And every time he walks in there, we're getting to witness greatness. You feel it when Anderson Silva walks up the steps. I remember staring across the octagon and going, holy cow, that's Anderson Silva. And he has that approach. He has that appeal to everyone that gets in front of him, not only in the octagon, but in life. One of the nicest guys you've ever met is Anderson Silva.
And a renewed focus on recovery and physical therapy has allowed the great Anderson Silva to compete deep into his 40s, DC. You ain't going to 45.
I'm not
There's
going
no way.
To 45. Ain't
You're
no out. Chance.
You're
going to
voice a video game.
I'm going to voice a video game. What a great idea.
Our tail of the tape for this much-anticipated middleweight encounter. Hall is 36. Silva is 45. He is 2 inches taller. Hall will have the 2-inch reach advantage. Here once more is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a karate fighter holding a professional record of 16 wins, 9 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Uriah Hall! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 34 wins, 10 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 6 feet 2 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Curitiba, Brazil, presenting the former UFC middleweight champion of the world, Anderson the Spider Silva! And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Levine.
The veteran Eve Levine draws the assignment here.
Are you ready?
Crowd getting excited as this fight gets underway, and you hate to call any fighter on this UFC roster a specialist, but on one side, you have a definite striker taking on a true five-tool player.
And you see a guy in the striker who knows exactly who he is. He knows where the fight needs to be. He knows what he has to do in order to be successful. Let's see if he can keep his opponent off of him.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
Silva gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up.
Hands up. Use your footwork now. It's okay. Use your footwork.
Wild attempt with the right hand there. Lands with the right hand. Paul's shot is blocked.
Look at him drive his shin into the opponent's body with that body kick.
Paul gets hit with that hook shot there. He's got to be careful to not allow the offense to follow up here.
Great punch.
Two minutes have expired off the round one clock here.
Look at him. whipped his hip into that kick.
Just out of range with that right hand.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Oh, you can feel the breeze there. Swing and a miss by Hall. Got the single collar tie.
He lands a big knee to the body.
And both guys really throwing with authority.
That knee.
Let's go.
That
do something.
Knee hurt him.
Come on, buddy. Keep your hands up. Let's go.
We got to fight, folks. Oh! So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Anderson the Spider Silver.
Punch over the top. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Unable to connect with the right hand.
One minute, stay working.
Body kick is blocked. 45 seconds remain in the round. Paul gets hit with a kick.
Oh!
Oh! All right, here, final seconds of round one. Oh, big left hook there. 5 minutes in the books. Let's check out some of the action now from that previous round, and he really kept finding a home for those kicks.
Yeah, and why would you change it? If your opponent is not going to check, if he's gonna stand there and he's not on his toes and he's stationary, you keep driving those kicks into his thighs, into his body, until he makes some sort of adjustment.
All right, DC, buckle up. Here we go with our next round. High number of kicks landed in the previous round, and he'll look to keep it going here.
He'll look to keep winning the fight with his kicks. He's throwing high kicks.
His opponent in a lot of trouble now.
That was Cain Velasquez's punch of choice. Every time he landed that overhand right, he hurt people bad. And this guy has his opponent hurt very badly again.
Well, he's been pretty accurate tonight. He's landed some significant strikes, but his corner's looking for him to mix it up a little bit more and just throw more volume.
Because they don't see too much of a threat. This guy has to have confidence in knowing that when he extends his combinations, he's still safe, but he's also gonna be able to land. He's gotta be finding that confidence in his mind that all the reps in the training room are going to pay off.
38 total strikes have landed for Anderson Silva. And landing half the shots tonight, 50% the accuracy rate against Uriah Hall. Hall's strike there is blocked. Nice job by the defense. Well, he's really starting to land a high number of strikes here in the second round. No denying that he has taken the message from his corner and picked up the pace here in round two.
Nice leg kick. Big, powerful punch land. Now he gets back to range.
Oh, that right hand is on point.
Ooh, head kick lands. Hurt. Look at the turnover in that kick.
Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Now look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
Well, these are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when.
All combination of ground strikes, DC. This could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you gotta be very careful when you take these big ground and pound strikes. You need to control posture on the bottom. And if you're the top guy, the guy that's looking to finish, continue to gain posture and rain down big strikes on your opponent.
Close guard. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you gotta be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Thunderous leg kick. A little bit, trying to stay upright. But man, that changed the complexion of this fight.
Johnny's hurt. He's hurt really badly by that one big leg kick.
All right, so there's the horn signifying the end of the round. A stunner there with the head strike midway through. Nearly got him out of there for good.
Almost got him out of there. He hurt him badly. He had his opponent hurt real bad. Now, his opponent's walking back to his corner. Everybody looks confused. They don't know what they're supposed to do to try to change the way that this fight is going.
All right, next round is now underway. Hopefully, the action continues at a high level. Pretty good first 5 minutes.
Pretty good first 5 minutes. Both of them can really pick it up. Let's see who decides they're going to lead the dance as we go forward.
Silva gets caught with that punch. Well, most fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. Head strikes.
Nice kick.
Right punches there.
I mean, he's cutting them down to size with this beautiful leg kick.
Oh, nice strike landed there by Silva.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Just over 3 minutes now to go in the fight. 75 total strikes have landed for Uriah. Oh, right over the top, right to the target. Let's see if his opponent can survive.
I cannot believe he is still standing after taking that punch.
Oh, he's landed a high number of total strikes here in the latter stages of this fight. He's really picked up the pace and landing far more strikes than he did in previous rounds.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one? Nice head kick.
Paul's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. He's always on the counterattack, but a nice leg kick there by Silva. Huge connection by him there.
He needs to get on his bicycle, John. He needs to get into space so that he doesn't get finished.
Well, looks as though his leg is hurt here. You can even see him limping a little bit. Oh!
Ooh, big shot lands. Way to hide that leg kick. Oh, man, head kick lands. Yeah, he's mixing it all up.
Silva gets hit with a kick. Well, he keeps going back to the well with that left hand, just out of range. What can you say? All right, so the fight goes the distance as we await the judges' scorecards, but certainly a dominant striking effort out of that fighter tonight.
John, he used his best weapons in order to carry him to a decision, a very clear decision, in my opinion. A great performance tonight by this young fighter.
Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. All three judges score this contest 9-28. Declaring the winner by unanimous decision, Anderson the Spider Silva!
right, so there he is. The celebration is on. He tried to leave the judges out of it tonight, was unable to do that, but a pretty dominant effort nonetheless. He's your winner by unanimous decision.
And you've got to feel good about that. You've got to feel good about dominating every aspect of a fight and getting a victory. He should be very proud of his performance tonight.